Good morning, dear students. Today we will revise all the formulas up to its a step. So first thing is sign convention. And that is very interesting and very easy. So whatever happens in front of the mirror, is taken as negative. When you have to understand sign convention, you have to keep mirror exactly in the center of the graph. So that is the x-axis, that is the y-axis. So you have to keep mirror exactly in the center of the graph. That means the pole of the mirror and the origin directly are the same point. So in this particular scenario, you all know y-axis is above positive, y-axis positive and below negative. That means x-axis is in principal axis. So height of the object is positive, and below negative. So you can understand sign convention. If we talk about in front of the scenario or in front of the mirror, that is the negative. In front of the mirror, negative, and behind of the mirror, it will be the positive. Or in the right, positive, x-axis. So just you have to remember this scenario, that basically sign convention is a graph. So everything above the principal axis, is positive, and below negative. Everything in front of the mirror, it will be the negative. And behind the mirror, positive. But you have to understand, for you have to know where the image exactly is. You have to get connected to ray diagram. So for that, your ray diagram should be perfectly clear. Because ray diagram is clear, so your sign convention will be clear. So these are the basic things that you should know about that. After sign convention, we enter into the mirror formula. What is the mirror formula? That is 1 by V plus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F. So V is the image distance, U is the object distance, and F is a focal length. So if you have two quantities, two variables, and so you have to find third variables. So that's the mirror formula. Now see the formulas of magnification. So first, for mirror and for lens. For mirror, height of the image by height of the object. So the definition of magnification is the ratio of height of the image to the height of the object is your magnification. Now other formula of magnification, that is minus V by U. V is image distance and U is object distance, taken as negative. Now we will see some significance. So if you will see the distance positive, that means positive be there behind, so image will be virtual. If positive be there, so image will be virtual. If negative be there, so image will be real. How will you find the image distance? If you have mirror, so you will find the image in front of the mirror in the principal axis. So if it is in front of the mirror, it is a negative. In front of the mirror, it will be the negative, and image will be the real. Now in magnification, M is less than 1, so image will be diminished. M is equal to 1, so image will be same sized. And image is greater than 1, so image will be enlarged. So we will understand this. If magnification is less than 1, so what is the formula of magnification? That is height of image by height of object, HI by HO, is less than 1. So here we transfer HO, this side. So HI is less than HO. That means height of image is less than height of object. So image will be diminished. If M is equal to 1, so again we have to put the value of, that is what is the formula? HI by HO. Again, we have to transfer HO this side. So HI is equal to HO. So image will be same size. If m is equal to 1, so the image will be same sized. Again, if m is greater than 1, if m is greater than 1, so we have to write the formula m, that is hi by ho is greater than 1. Again, we have to transfer ho this side. So hi is greater than ho, that means height of image is greater than height of object. So here image will be enlarged rather than the height of object. If you have the value of magnification, if you have the value of the magnification is positive, so image will be erect. If value of magnification is negative, image is inverted. If concave mirror is there, so it will be negative. If concave mirror is there, so it will be negative. If convex mirror is there, is convex mirror is there, it will be the positive. So what is the difference between mirror formula and lens formula? What is the difference between the mirror formula and lens formula? Only sign will be changed. In mirror formula, you will see the plus sign. In lens formula, you will see the minus sign. So only sign will be changed here. In the mirror formula, plus sign be there. In the lens formula, minus sign be there. So whatever is there in front of the lens, it will be the negative, and behind the lens, positive will be there. Whatever is there above, that's the positive, and below, negative will be there. So these are the difference between the lens formula and mirror formula. What happens in magnification? Hm is equal to hi by ho. It will be the same, but in case of the mirror, here negative sign will be there. So minus v by u in mirror, but in lens formula, we will see the magnification. V by u will be there. So in case of the mirror, minus sign, and in the case of the lens, plus sign be there or positive sign be there. And the significance, the difference is there in image only. All the inferences will be same. In that, so difference is there in image only. Image only, all the inferences will be same. In that, if image is positive, so it will be the real. And if negative, so it will be the virtual. So that is the difference. Except the image, all the inferences are same. So these are the basic formulas. So these are the basic formulas what you have to keep in your mind.